are so many people out on the streets, and even when they find a place, a little piece of ground that they can set up their tent, we see the ongoing harassment by the city officials and the county officials telling them to move on. We're seeing so many people that can't even lay their head anywhere. Tony's joining me, and Tony, you're out on daily outreach. Yeah, you were telling me earlier that they're shutting down another encampment.
Yes, sir. There's one out there off of Chateau and Vandeventer, and we pulled up there yesterday, and there was police all over, and they were standing around telling everybody they had to move. It was private property, and they need to move their belongings, and people were all huddled up in their tents and afraid to come out, so we went ahead and asked permission if it wouldn't bother them if we fed them and got them something to eat.
What'd they say when you asked them, can you feed them?
Well, one said he'd rather I didn't, but he said just go ahead.
Because Jesus would rather that you did.
Yeah, amen, yeah.
Amen. So you're out here with these people on a daily basis, and seeing them. Tell me your reflection on such an outreach.
No, it's something else. That's the second place I've actually seen in the last 2 days that the same thing was going on. They were taking up all their belongings and everything and loading them up into dump trucks and hauling them out of there. Now these people are going to be wandering around the city looking for a new place to lay their head.
Going into people's backyards and everywhere else.
Yeah, they were said there was a lot of theft going on in that area, but
I even see them setting the stage over at the pallet yard. They won't work with them to try to get that dumpster emptied, so letting the trash accumulate so then they can come along, because they're the owner of the private property, said they could stay, and they're trying to find an excuse to go after that encampment too. Just the sweeps are taking place.
Yeah, by all the trash falling from there. It's sad. There's this desperate need for a large shelter in this city, and now in many other cities I've seen across America as well. There's thousands and thousands being put out on the streets nowadays, and it's really a heartbreaking deal every day to go out and see this as I'm on the outreach providing sandwiches and things through New Life.
And over 650 tents and sleeping bags and the like.
Yeah.
Well, we got a lot of them around here today. We're distributing clothes and doing bus tickets and other direct assistance that's coming up. Let me talk to Glenn over here a minute. You help do county outreach. What's going on in the county?
Same thing. They've on our North County outreach, they've you can see it from the 370. They completely cleared out this wooded line that the people were over by the Loves, and they were going back and forth into St. Charles County, and St. Charles County cleared out their downtown area.
Well, I know a family with two little girls that live over in that area. They pushed them out of there?
Yes. All the downtown got bulldozed and cleared out. In fact, if you go up, I forget the name of the street, but right by the McDonald's there, the wood line right next to the creek got completely torn apart.
We're going to have to engage in some direct advocacy and civil disobedience, because people are sticking their heads in the sand. Holidays coming. They'll go and they'll worship Christ, who's born in a manger and who said, "As oft he done to the least of these, so he done to me." They call it worship. They sing songs about him, talk about him. When it comes to the homeless that exist out there, like Jesus did, and he told us what to do, seems like that's ignored.
Yeah, and it's really sad when you get right down to it, because the government is clearing out these encampments, but there's no place for these people to go, so they just got to set up camp somewhere else where they'll get cleared out again. And it's basically a game of shuffle them around.
We try to find them and get them out to our different training centers, don't we?
Oh, yes, all the time. Yeah, every time that we go to an encampment, we always let them know about our men's leadership program and our women's in need program.
Well, there's a young man behind us over here that you're helping to mentor, aren't you?
Yes, that's Malachi.
This is Malachi, and Malachi, this man's giving you some training in TV work, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Our outreach teams, we're reaching out to you, and I also know that you... when you were out on the streets yourself, you got beat up, didn't you?
I did.
So what did it mean to you? How did it change your life by coming to New Life Evangelistic Center and the Residential Living Program?
It meant everything to new hope, a new fresh start, and new safety that I haven't felt in a while before coming into the program.
So living out on the streets, now going out to our training center and farm in New Bloomfield. And now you're behind a camera here, right?
Yes, I am.
God is a miracle-working God. Did you ever dream that when you were out there and getting beat up?
No. I didn't even think I would make it out of the streets, if I was being 100% honest.
But the Lord got you out of the streets.
Yes, he did.
He's a miracle-working God. Lives are being changed all over. Let's come over and talk to Chris over here. Chris, how you doing? You were once out there. You were once homeless. How's the Lord changed your life by being in the training program?
Remarkable ways.
Has it changed your life?
It has got to do a lot of different things. Worked in renewable energy. I've worked with the Channel 24 people and gone out with Reverend Ray, which is always enjoyable. Now, work with your wife?
Yes, you work faithfully, and y'all gather up food. You distribute it to the food banks. You help out. William, how are you today? You work together with Chris, don't you?
Yes, I do.
And what's it meant to you to be involved in the training program?
I changed my life around. It's being helpful to society. I like that.
God is a miracle-working God, isn't he?
Yes.
Yes, he is.
Lots of homeless people here. You're bringing out clothes, helping them?
Yes.
A lot of them around here that need help today, right?
That's right. Every day.
God bless you. Well, it's not only the men. We also have the opportunity for the women. Donna? Donna? Donna, you came from Springfield, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
Right. And Angela, you've been with us a few years.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Well, how's it changed your life?
Well, it made me get closer to God, and I started coming out helping people, giving out stuff, praying for people.
So that's made a big difference in your life.
Yes.
Donna, you are out here ministering to the people now, and you were homeless yourself. What was it like being homeless in Springfield?
It was very rough.
Was it?
Yeah, I had everything stolen from me, and I didn't know where I was going to go until I got to the V8, and I got some help from...
It's a Veterans Coming Home Center run by the New Life Evangelistic Center, isn't it?
Yes.
So you
yes.
came here, you're working together with Angela, or you're staying with Angela, you're working downtown, yes. You help prepare a lot of these bags of food, don't you?
Yes, sir, I do. Yeah, I work in the lunchroom.
How does it make you feel to do that?
Oh, it gives me such joy in my heart and in my soul that it's amazing that God works in people's lives.
And even if you've done this in obedience unto the Lord, you also have been reunited with your mother, haven't you?
Yes, I have. Yes, thank you to this program that I'm in. I have been reunited with her.
Well, we want to take this time for you just to meet some of the lives that are being changed. Frequently you hear from the homeless people. We'll continue to let you hear from them. But at this time, we want to bring you an update on lives that are being transformed through the grace of our resurrected Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because those that are praying for New Life Evangelistic Center and those that are sharing your tax-deductible gifts at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can go online to NLECSTL.org and just let the light and love of Christ shine in you and through you and watch him do exceedingly beyond what you can ask. Good thing as you partner with New Life Evangelistic Center to be there when people are hurting.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great today.
I'm out here on this brisk morning here. A lot of people needing help, aren't there?
Need a lot of help. Yeah. Yes.
And here we're blessed to be able to give you this hygiene kit here. And if somebody put a scripture on here, it says, "For God so loved the world," has John 3:16.
I love reading that book.
And it has a devotional book plus a lot of hygiene items. Wash rag or a towel there, and toothpaste,
wipes.
Wow, all of these things are things that people ask for when we're out in the streets, and we're glad that we can give this to you.
Thank you.
And also help you with some bus tickets, too. Tell us how important it is for you.
Oh, it's really important. I come down here to get some bus tickets and hygiene stuff so I could go to do an interview, get a job. Yeah, I need a job.
That if you have an appointment for an interview, if you can't get to the place, that's pretty bad. So we're trying to empower people so that they can get the jobs, the employment, the things that they need in their lives.
Yes, you have to. It's just bad out here.
Remember, it's all through the glory of the Lord Jesus. That's why.
Amen.
That's why they put that scripture on there, just as a reminder.
Right.
It's God's love that provides these things.
Amen.
Well, God bless you. Here you go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Reverend Rice. Thank you.
New Life Evangelistic Center here in St. Louis, Missouri. And who am I speaking with today?
Charles.
Charles, how are you doing this morning, Charles?
So-so.
So-so. Why are you here this morning, brother?
Get bus tickets and clothing.
Get some bus tickets and clothing. Is it providing the things you need to help survive on these streets here
very
in St.
Much,
Louis?
Very much.
Well, we're glad you could be with us this morning. And many of the people here getting their needs met by New Life Evangelistic Center in St. Louis, Missouri. We want to pray that you have a blessed day, brother, and that you stay with the Lord and you get the things you need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So this hygiene kit, wow, that's a big one here, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, these are made by a lot of times by different church groups. A church group put John 3:16 on here, and inside they have some very, very helpful items, the
very
towel.
Usable items.
Yeah.
Very usable items when we out here.
Tell us what it means to you.
It means a lot to me. It means I can keep clean. I can get up, keep myself fresh, keep going. I don't have to be embarrassed about how I look, how I smell.
Yeah.
I'm fresh.
Yeah.
I'll be able to go out on interviews and all that.
Praise God. So it's very practical, very helpful. And, you know, church groups can make these. They can put these together and bring them to New Life Evangelistic Center in a Ziploc bag like this.
Socks, T-shirts, gloves, scarves.
All those things are needed.
Anything to keep us warm.
This winter time now, as we're getting into the very cold weather, you know, all of those items are greatly needed. And the churches can have a coat drive. They can have a put together
winter
care
outreach.
Kits. Yeah. And they can join us for winter outreach. If you want to contact me, it's Ray Redlich at New Life Evangelistic Center, 314-421-3020. We can talk about even going out on the streets. If your church wants to gather sleeping bags and put together care kits and sandwiches and things like that, we can take you out on the streets and distribute these directly to the people that are benefiting. So, or you can bring them to New Life. You know, whatever works best. But okay. God bless you. And we
they are needed.
Amen.
They are needed.
Thank you. And we're going to help you with some bus tickets here,
thank
too.
Thank you so much.
To help you get around.
Thank you so much.
God bless you.
Appreciate you. Thank you.
And who am I speaking with today?
I'm Grandin.
Grandin. We're here with New Life Evangelistic Center in the streets of downtown St. Louis, Missouri this morning, speaking with a brother from the homeless. Are you homeless, my brother?
Currently homeless, St. Louis, Missouri, but I'm residing where I can, I have a shelter roof over my head. I sleep my family members allow me to be there in the facility, the house and stuff.
Hey, man, it's tough out here, and the weather's getting colder, and we had a couple of days of rain this week. How did that affect you on the street?
Oh, man, it affected me because it kind of affected me in my work commute, but thanks to you guys helping me out with bus tickets, I was able to catch the metro bus, you know, so I got a little down, but I wasn't too wet.
Yeah, we covered a lot of tent cities and a lot of homeless people the other days when it was raining, and we give out a lot of blankets to the people. It's clothing that got wet, their tents were leaking, and they were just sitting there freezing wet and starving and sitting on the streets of St. Louis, Missouri. How do you feel about this, brother?
With that being said, with the help that y'all do give to them, I know that them blankets and stuff was very needed, because I've been down here and got clothes and warm socks and even hot food sometimes down here. So what that means to me is, like, that's changing, because a lot of people won't take the time to even look at you or give you something or donate it, and they ride right past you.
Hey, man, many people fear the homeless as if they've got some kind of disease or something. And
exactly.
They've got to realize they're brothers and sisters in Christ just as well.
Exactly, and we are one nation. We are one nation.
Amen. Well, you have a blessed day, brother, and glad you could be with us this morning.
No problem, no problem.
Amen. Here we are this morning with New Life Evangelistic Center. Who am I speaking with?
Eugene Mitchell, Jr.
Eugene Mitchell, Jr. How are you doing this morning, Eugene?
I'm blessed and highly favored to be here in the name of God.
Amen. God gathers all of us together to spread his word, does he not?
Yes, he does.
How is New Life Evangelistic Center meeting your needs on the streets today?
You mean how is New Life Evangelist assisting with saving my life?
Hey.
Well, being out here, living out here outdoors, is saving my life, helps save my life through the hygiene bags that you all give us, to just the water, the clothes that you provide, the bus tickets to be able to get around, hopefully find a job, or to get, you know, a lot of people get to put in these positions, and it's not a lot of times their fault. It's just life in major cities around the world. You know, 45% of the people on this planet can't cook their own food. That's almost half. So there are a lot of people all over this planet, in St. Louis specifically, like most inner cities, homeless people like me, that are right now worried about freezing to death this winter. And what you all do, by blankets, coats, the clothing, to the bus tickets, to the hygiene bags, just to stay clean. You know, people somehow look down on homeless people like they're not even human.
Yeah, they treat us as if they're less than the person in the vehicle or the person in the home.
Yes.
But they don't realize we're all brothers and sisters in Christ.
We're all cousins. We're all children of Adam, children of God. And what I'm saying is that just by the hygiene bag, when you go around someone and you don't smell good because you've been outside, that throws people off naturally. The hygiene bags.
Yeah,
you know how hard it is for someone living outside to stay clean every day? It's a lot harder. harder. I've lived in houses most of my life, and I've been out here 4 years. And I can tell you it's a lot easier to do it when you're living inside shelter. When you're outside, do you know how much work it takes just to not smell funky?
Yeah, it's also impossible to get a job, is it not?
Would you want to go to Church's or Lee's right now where they're charging $6 for 2 pieces of chicken, inflation, dark, and the guy behind the counter stinks? Would you want to pay $6 for 2 pieces of chicken? The guy smells and reeks? I don't think you would. And so that's what you do. You help us with our personal pride, hygiene, staying alive, staying from freezing to death in the wintertime.
Well, may the Lord be with you today, my brother, and bless you and always. Thank you for having your interview with us.
Thank you so much for the privilege of doing this interview, and thank you for Mr. Rice. No one, he doesn't get enough credit.
You have a blessed day, my brother.
You too.
You need some hygiene kits, is that
yes,
right?
Yes, sir. I need hygiene kits. I need bus tickets. I need a bag. Nothing.
Okay, well, how important is it that a new life is out here?
Very important to me. Very important. Always have been. Yeah. It always has been important. Because I tell people all the time, you're a great help to a lot of people. I don't care what they say about you.
But here you go.
And that's
here,
the truth. God bless you. Oh, God bless you got you, one with the socks and socks in them?
No, we need people to donate. We need people to donate some socks.
No,
they give them to us or bring them on.
The guy just had one.
Well, you know, people bring us these, and sometimes they put them in, sometimes they don't.
Right, and I understand.
Handing them, so I want to ask you to just continue to pray for us.
I'll continue to pray for everyone.
This one don't have socks either. So, folks, please make up the hygiene kits. And put some socks in them, folks. Thank you.
Dwayne Murphy, how are we helping your needs being met here today?
Helping with some clothes or bus tickets to get around and look for work.
New Life Evangelistic Center gathers every Friday downtown St. Louis here and helps provide the things for the homeless and needy in this area. We provide sandwiches, health hygiene kits, bus tickets, clothing, and many things to help us. How's this been a blessing for you today, brother?
Well, it's been a blessing because I need this. You know, I've been knowing Larry Rice in a real long time. I used to be in their program and everything.
Amen.
Too.
Well, trust in the Lord.
They're doing what they're doing. You know, I know he's been trying to get some bills around here, but they won't, you know, let him get them. You know, he do more, help the homeless more than the city do, and I appreciate you what he's doing.
Yeah, the needs are growing every day on these streets in St. Louis, Missouri. Well, God be with you today, my man.
So
you
too.
Have a blessed day, brother.
You too.
Amen.
How are you today?
How you doing? How you doing, Reverend Ray?
I'm pretty good. Good. How have you been doing?
I'm hanging in there, you know.
How does this
one day at a time. Oh, man, you got to stay clean, you know. Being in this situation, it's hard to get stuff like this, you know. You guys, even though I'm homeless, you know, I gotta maintain.
It's very practical, isn't it?
Yeah, yes it is.
And so I've got a couple bus tickets for you here too. Can you
and I work too.
Tell us how that's gonna help you.
This is this will help me get to my appointments, my Afrenia appointments, any kind of interview I might have, just going to see my family, you know, all that type of stuff.
God bless you.
Thank you. Have a good day.
I'm Anthony Vogt here with New Life Evangelistic Center in St. Louis, Missouri. And who am I speaking with today?
Edward.
Edward, how can you tell us about the things that are going on in this city and on the streets and the ever-growing needs of all the people in our community?
It's a good thing that Larry Rice has something going on every week, you know, every Friday, to get resources to connect us with bus transportation, resources to get us meals to eat, beverages, drink, clothing, shoes. You know, it's just all types of stuff that he's doing to help us out.
Just every Friday morning, we gather down here near the Chestnut and what is this other street right here? down here off Chestnut, and we're giving away food and bus tickets and clothing to help the homeless here in St. Louis, Missouri. How do these things help you in your life?
It helps me a good, great deal, you know. That way I don't have to walk too much, and I can have a full belly to get where I'm going, you know, extra strength, extra energy, and it also supports me in doing something more positive for myself to move, go the extra mile.
Meeting the basic needs of the people in our community. Well, I want to pray with you today, brother. I pray that the Lord puts his hands upon you and changes your life and gives you the things you need to survive in this cruel world in which we live in today. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Good morning, sir.
How are you doing today?
Blessed.
It's a sunny day, a little nippy out here.
Yeah, it's a little chilly. Yes, sir. I got my got my overall that I got from you guys last week.
Oh, really?
I was blessed. Well, yes, sir.
No, it's so important that we can come out here on Friday mornings like this and give out not only the food and the bus tickets and that, but also clothing, you know.
Yes, my overall. You guys have been a great help for our community. You know, we still got to wait for the winter time to come through. It's just the fall now, so bear with us. With Reverend Rice and his helpers, they have been a really blessing to our community. So if you guys are watching, just pray for us that we'll have a better chance out here. It's just hard for a lot of people that's out here. I'm not by myself. I'm with everybody that's out here. So just pray for us if you guys can.
Amen. Prayer is so important, and God gives us an opportunity sometimes to be the answer to our prayers as
we
step out and help. You know, church groups can put together these care kits like this. That's a real blessing. There's hygiene items in it, towel and the toothpaste, toothbrush, razor, and all those things. And those are such a blessing to people on the streets, I'm thinking.
Yes, sir. And it's very expensive, too. You look in this bag, it's about a $20 to $30 bag. If you go to the store and have to purchase any of this stuff, it's very expensive. So we're grateful for Reverend Rice and his help. Amen. That he have down here to help us. God bless you. Thank you, sir.
Help with transportation, too. God bless you. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
This is Anthony Vogt with New Life Evangelistic Center in downtown St. Louis, Missouri. Who am I speaking with today?
He's speaking to Mr. Griffin, Jesse Griffin.
Jeffrey Griffin, how are you today, my brother?
I'm all right, thank God.
How has New Life Evangelistic Center met your needs this morning here on the downtown St. Louis, Missouri?
Well, I've been getting back and forth on this new job I got. I've been using the chicken for that to get me back and forth. I just gained me a new apartment.
Good.
You know, I'm off the streets right now, so that's good. Keeping me head above water.
We're glad we were able to provide bus tickets to help you get back and forth to work.
Right.
Without a job, a man will be out on the streets.
Yes, he will. I mean, that's a part-time job because I get SSI. It's just a part-time job.
Amen. But every little bit helps in this society. Well, we're glad you could be with us this morning and know that the Lord is always with us and he's watching out over his children.
Yes, sir.
We're glad that you could come in with us this morning and share your testimony. And you have a blessed day, my brother.
You too.
Amen.
You are, sir.
You need a hygiene kit.
Yes, I do.
I understand you also want to get off these streets and get into our residential living program. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay. What is your name?
My name is Vincent Childers.
Vincent, you've been on the streets a long time?
Oh, get quite a while, yeah.
All right. We've got to break that cycle of homelessness. That's why we have our residential living program. They go out to New Bloomfield and here.
It's a blessing. Thank you for everything. And it's such a blessing to have you out here and doing what you do. And I do appreciate everything.
Well, I appreciate all of you that are responding to the call of the Lord. He said, when I was hungry, did you feed me? We're trying to give them food. Naked, did you clothe me? Clothing. Sick or in prison, did you visit me? Stranger, did you welcome me? He said, as oft you've done to the least of these, even so you've done to me. And those of you that are sharing right now through the love of Jesus are making such a big difference in the lives of the hurting and homeless.
This is Anthony Vogt on the streets of New Life with New Life Evangelistic Center in St. Louis, Missouri. And who am I speaking with today?
I'm Kevin, sir.
Kevin, how are you doing today, Kevin?
I'm blessed, sir. God opened up my eyes to come up here to see you all, to get bus tickets, to get to work. Yes,
amen,
sir.
Yes. We're trying to meet the ever-growing needs of people here on the streets of St. Louis, Missouri with New Life Evangelistic Center Outreach Program. And how have we met your needs today, brother?
We met my needs today by I have a lunch, I have bus tickets to get to and fro from my job and from my home as well. So Mr. Rice helping me out every Friday is a blessing.
And as the growing number here seems to grow on a weekly basis.
It does. It's growing. It seems like they doubled up this week.
Amen.
Today. Yep.
Well, you have a blessed day, brother, and may God be with you.
God be with you all.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I see you got your care kits.
Yes.
There, the hygiene kit with a lot of real helpful items.
Exactly.
And we're glad that we can
things that we can use.
Yeah.
You know, it's very handy. It's handy, it's useful, and it's easy to get to, you know what I'm saying? Because sometimes you can't get to the restroom. You just got to do what you got to do outside because you're homeless, you know, and it's hard. So this give us a great blessing. A message and a lesson.
And it has a little devotion.
Yes,
book in it.
And I love these.
And even the deodorant.
Yes.
Too. Those are probably at a premium out there.
And also has. I thought they had them Q-tips.
I think I saw somebody had
Q-tips. I knew it was somebody in here got Q-tips. Them come in handy too.
Oh, wow.
Ain't worried about it. There's a blessing that's by itself.
Yeah, here's some bus tickets.
Thank
for you.
I appreciate you.
God bless you.
God bless you all.
Scott, how are you doing this morning?
I'm doing great. I'm really thankful for this service that happens every Friday.
Amen. There's plenty of people showing up this morning for this rally. How are we providing for your needs this morning?
Well, I'm in a catch-22. I'm unemployed, and as soon as I get work, I'll be able to afford my own transit to get around. But I need transit to get to job interviews and to get to my work until that first paycheck.
Yeah, there's homelessness addresses many problems throughout the world, unemployment, and there's such thing, you know, evictions, and then just people losing their home, period, are flooding the streets of America with the homeless population. And your man is just out of work and out here on the street.
Right, and I want to work, but I need to get to job interviews, so I'm grateful for the bus tickets that I can get here.
Yeah, it's hard to get a job without an address, isn't it?
Right.
Well, God bless you and be with you today, brother. Have a blessed day.
Okay, thank you. You too.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
So, tell us how important it is to be able to get some help today.
Well, it's important to get bus tickets because I had a Monday bus pass that was stolen, so I really, really need these bus tickets today so I can continue, you know, my journey besides just standing around, you know.
Did you get your care kit yet?
Yep, got it right here.
Okay, good. I'm glad that we can help you with that. Here's some bus tickets for you. God bless you. I hope this will really help you.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, with New Life Evangelistic Center here in St. Louis, Missouri. And who am I speaking with today?
Steve.
Steve, how are the needs of yours being met by the New Life Evangelistic Center down here in downtown St. Louis on this morning?
I got a pair of socks. The bus seat helped me get to a different ministry before I take a shower, job, going to different ministry to get somebody.
It's tough out here on the streets, isn't it?
Yes, yep.
We have a large gathering here every Friday morning out here, and we're giving away bus tickets, food, water, and clothing to the homeless to help provide for the needs of this ever-failing economy, Oregon. What is your blessing today, my man?
Larry Rice.
Larry Rice, amen. And this is New Life Evangelistic Center coming to you live from the streets of St. Louis, Missouri. Amen.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing fine.
So you need a hygiene kit,
yes,
too?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. What is your name?
I'm Grand.
All right. Well, here you go.
All right.
And so how important is that to you?
It's so important, man, because I need this to, you know what I'm saying, keep my hormones. I mean, I'm a hormones, but my personal hygiene. Yeah, so when clean. I go back and forth to work, man, so this is really a need for me.
Well, we thank
keep
God.
Some money in my pocket from having to go to Family Dollar or something.
All right. Well, God bless you, my friend. Hi, you need a hygiene kit? What is your name?
Edward,
so you, what does it mean? You're homeless now.
Yes.
What does this mean to you?
It means a great deal, you know, mm-hmm. that I can get a hygiene kick from you all to keep myself up, you know, for the job and just for everyday life, you know, just because some people don't like to have you enter buildings being unclean, you know.
Yeah.
So you have to keep yourself in a good perspective, especially when you work.
Well, God bless all of you that get these hygiene kits together for the toothbrush, toothpaste, razor, deodorant, soap, and put them in a gallon bag here so we can put them right in the hands of the homeless. And you need those, do you?
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, we thank God for those that are given, don't we?
Yes.
Surely the Lord is good. Isn't he good?
Yes, all the time.
Thank God for all of you that are sharing right now. While we're doing this, they're also doing bus tickets over here. Individuals getting bus tickets, and that's meeting a need. So many needs are being met because of those of you sharing with New Life, and God bless you, my friend. And you need something too like this, do you? Well, here you go. I just want you to know how much the Lord loves you.
Yes, he loves you also.
It makes a big difference, doesn't it?
Yes, you do.
How we thank God for all of you that are just letting the light and love of Christ shine in you and through you. And please continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center.